हेलो किड्स, शुभम मंगलम एट लिटिल स्कॉलर हाई स्कूल। आई एम संगीता सिंह, टेकिंग सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश। एंड द टॉपिक टू बी डिस्कस टुडे इज यूनिट वन, स्टडी मटेरियल। नाउ इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव डन वोकैबुलरी एंड ग्रामर। नाउ इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डू एडिटिंग। नाउ व्हाट इज एडिटिंग? एडिटिंग इज आइडेंटिफाइंग द मिस्टेक्स और द एरर्स एंड करेक्टिंग इट। सो लेट अस डू एडिटिंग। क्वेश्चन नंबर्स 27 to 31। नाउ हियर वी हैव द पैसेजेस। पैसेज वन, नाउ लेट अस सी। नाउ रीराइट द फॉलोइंग पैसेज गिवन बिलो। सो रीराइट मींस राइट द पैसेज अगेन, यूज द गिवन बिलो। फाइव सेंटेंसेस इन द पैसेज आर नंबर्ड। सो five sentences in the passage are numbered, means each sentence has a number at the beginning, and each of these five sentences has an error. Error is a mistake, so we have to correct and rewrite them in your book. So each question carries 2 marks. So 5 questions, it is 10 marks question. So you need to be very careful, kids. Now passage 1, the animals, birds and trees were exiles. So your sentence is numbered as 27 at the beginning. So the animals, birds and trees were. So were is the helping verb which is used in the past tense. So after that, the verb excites should be changed to past tense excited. Excites is present tense. It should be changed to past tense excited. Here we are talking about the animals, birds and trees were. So were is a plural verb which is used in the past tense. It's a helping verb which is used in the past tense. Was is helping verb which is used in the present past tense, but it is used for singular verb. And were is a plural verb which is used in the past tense. So here we should use the verb excites should be changed to excited in the past tense. So let us rewrite this sentence again. 27th one, you should write the animals, birds and trees were excited. The word excites should be changed to excited. Question number 28. They began to prepare for the great day when they would give their best to the great one, except the little gray squirrel. They began to prepare. So here the word began is in past tense. The verb began is in past tense. So after the next verb prepared, it is in past tense. But we should not use both the verbs in the past tense. So after began, the next verb prepared should be in present tense. So they began to prepare. So right, they began to prepare. For the great day. The remaining sentence should be continued. Now question number 29. There were excitement in the air. Excitement is uncountable noun. So we should use the singular verb was in place of were. So were stands for plural and was is singular. So as excitement is an uncountable noun, we always use singular verbs with uncountable nouns. So the verb were should be used with replaced with was. So we say there was excitement. There was excitement in the air. So the verb were should be replaced with was. Now question number 30. There was going to be the grand contest. So we are talking about not a particular contest. There was going to be a contest. That is, it's a competition. So here the verb the article the indicates we are talking about a particular contest. But here it is not a particular contest. It can be a single contest, one contest. So here the article the should be replaced with article a. So we write, they was going to be a grand contest. Now question number 31. Everyone should show something special, and the best one would be praised with the lots of fire, wind, water and sun. So here everyone should show something special, and the best one would be praised. After the word praised, the word with, it is a preposition. It is not the right preposition to be used after praise. So after praise, the right preposition to be used is by. So they should be praised by the lords of fire, wind, water and sun. So write the answer. Everyone should show something special, and the best one would be praised. Everyone would be praised by the lords of fire. Fire, wind, water and sun. So here, so we have done, we have identified the mistakes and we have corrected the mistakes and we have rewritten the each sentence in the passage. So let us underline the places where we have corrected the mistakes. So they began to prepare, there was excitement, a grand contest and praised by. So here once again, the animals, birds and the trees were excited. So the word excites in the passage should be replaced with the word excited. They began to prepared. Here according to the passage it is given as prepared. The word prepared should be replaced with prepare. There were excitement in the air. So the word were should be replaced with was. There was going to be the grand contest is given in the passage. But you need to replace the article the with the article a. Now everyone should show something special, and the best one would be praised with the lots of fire. In the passage it is given with the lots of fire. So the preposition with should be replaced with the preposition by. Now let us see the second passage. Turn to page number 28, all of you. Now question number 27. I have everything grand to offer you. I have everything grand to offer you. Now sentence 28 says, I didn't glow or sing, but what I have I give with my heart, and he scampered away. 29th sentence, he returned, dragged his dry branches. 30th sentence says, a great one looked grave. 31 says, I see beauty in form or sound, all waited holding their breath. Now come back to sentence 27, I have everything grand to offer you. So here the word everything should be replaced with, it's wrong, it should be replaced with nothing. I have nothing grand to offer you. According to the lesson, the grand contest in the forest, the squirrel, the little gray squirrel says, I have nothing to offer you. So 27th one is, I have everything should be replaced with nothing. I have nothing grand to offer you. Now question number 28. I didn't glow or sing, but what I have I give with my heart. So here the word didn't is in past tense, but according to the passage it should be in present tense. So I don't glow. The squirrel says, I don't. Don't is present tense, didn't is past tense. So, I don't glow or sing. Next question number 29. He returned, drag his dry branches. So, the mistake is here, drag. The word drag should be replaced with dragging. Drag is present tense. It should be in present participle. Dragging. ING form of drag should be used. The verb drag. So, he returned, comma, dragging. The verb drag should be replaced with its present participle form, dragging his dry branches. Question number 30. A great one looked grave. So we are talking about only one great one. There is only one great one in this lesson, and we are talking about a particular person. So we cannot use the article a. A means one. So it should be replaced with the article the. So whenever you are talking about a particular person, we use the article the. So the great one looked grave. Question number 31. I see beauty in form or sound. So when you are talking about seeing beauty in two things, form or sound. So when you are talking about two similar things or two positive qualities, so the conjunction or is there, it should be replaced with and. So whenever you talk about two positive qualities, we use the conjunction and. Whenever you talk about two opposite qualities, we use the conjunction or. So here, or should be replaced with and. So you see, I see beauty in form and sound. So now, look at this. So what is it we have changed here? Edited. I have everything grand to offer you. So the word everything is replaced with nothing. Now, I didn't glow or sing. According to the passage, it is I didn't glow or sing. So didn't is past tense. It should be replaced with the present tense. I don't glow or sing. Now, question number 29. He returned, drag his dry branches. So here the word drag, which is in present tense, should be replaced with its present participle, that is the ing form, dragging. So drag changes to dragging. The great one, a great one looked grave. According to the passage, it is a great one looked grave. But we are talking about great one. We know who is the great one, about whom we are talking about. So the word, the article a should be replaced with the, because a represents one person. It can be any person. But when we are talking about the article the, whenever you are talking about a particular person whom we know, we use the article the. So the great one looked grave. Now, I see beauty in form or sound is given in the passage. But just now I explained you already that whenever you're talking about the two qualities, form and sound, isn't it? Two positive qualities, we use the conjunction and, but not or. So underline and here. Now let us look at third passage. Question number 27. The sadhu brought together the lions and the rabbits to a common meal. Question sentence 28. He visits the python and the viper and had a long chat with them. So 29th sentence is, he advised an eagle not to attack the little chicks that had lost their mother. Sentence 30 says, the sadhu accompanied the tiger and the wild bear to the near market. 31 sentence says, he played with the bulbul, the owl and the monkey. Now let us come back to sentence which is number 27. The sadhu brought together the lions and the rabbits to a common meal is given. So the preposition to is not the right usage of it is. So when you are bringing together, brought together the lines to a common meal is wrong. It should be for a common meal. So the preposition to should be replaced with for. It is the right usage of the preposition. So write the sadhu brought together the lions and the rabbits for a common meal. Question number 28. He visits the python and the viper and had a long chat with them. So here in the first sentence we said sadhu brought. The word brought, it is a verb which is in past tense. Now here in the second sentence, he visits the python and the viper. So visits is in present tense. So according to the passage, the verb visit should be changed to past tense visited. So right, he visited. He visited the python and the viper. Question number 29. He advised a eagle not to attack the little chicks that had lost their mother. So here the sadhu is talking about a particular eagle who has attacked the little chicks. So that's why we should say the article a should be replaced with the article the, because we are talking about a particular eagle who had attacked the little chicks. So a represents any eagle. It can be a eagle, means it can be an eagle. So but since we are talking about the eagle, eagle which has attacked the little chicks, so the article a should be replaced with the article the. So he advised the eagle not to attack the little chicks. Question number 30. The sadhu accompanied the tiger and the wild bear to the near market. So here the word near, near is positive degree. So we are talking about going to the market which is very near. So we use the comparative degree, nearest market. There can be many markets in the surrounding area. So we say nearest market. So we have to use the superlative degree of near. Near is positive, nearer is comparative, and nearest is superlative degree. So which is very near, a market which is very near to it. So we say the word nearest. So write the sadhu accompanied the tiger and the wild bear to the nearest market. There might be many markets in the surrounding area, but we are talking about the market which is very near among all the markets. So we use the comparative degree nearest. So now let us see the question. Sentence 31. He played with the bulbul, the owl and the monkey. So here according to the passage, according to the lesson, he played with the bulbul, the owl and the monkey. It is not monkey, it should be monkeys, because there were a group of monkeys here. So right, he played. He played with the bulbul, the owl and the monkeys. Now let us see, repeat once. The sadhu brought together the lions and the rabbits for a common meal. So here the preposition to should be replaced with for. Now, question number 28. He visited the python and the viper. So here it was visits in the passage. So visit should be replaced with visited. He visited the python and the viper. So visited is past tense and visit is present tense. So underline visited. He advised the eagle not to attack the little chicks. So actually, according to the passage, it was a eagle. So the article a is replaced with the eagle. The sadhu accompanied the tiger and the wild bear to the near market is given in the passage. So we have replaced near with nearest. He played with the bulbul, the owl and the monkey. So the monkey is replaced with monkeys. Now let us do section C, conventions of writing. Now what do you mean by conventions of writing? It is also called as writing conventions. So what do you mean by convention? It is a standard set of rules which are used for writing. So it is a standard set of rules which are to be followed for writing. For example, like using the correct spelling or using the correct pronunciation, punctuation marks and writing the correct grammar is called as conventions of writing. Now let us see, it's called as question number 32 and this carries 5 marks. So now we have to let me read the passage and we have to rewrite it using proper punctuation marks. So I'll read the passage. Now we have to rewrite this passage using, rewrite means write the passage again using proper punctuation marks. So what do you mean by punctuation marks? Using capital letters wherever required, using the question mark or full stop or exclamatory mark or inverted commas wherever required is called punctuation, using proper punctuation. Now, what is the use of this proper punctuation marks? It helps a reader in understanding the passage clearly. It helps the reader in understanding the passage clearly. So that is the main use of conventions of writing. Now look at the first passage. The creatures then marveled, saying, "How foolish we were to think only of the present. 3 cheers for the little squirrel." So here there is no, when you read it, there is no meaning for it. We don't understand the meaning of the passage clearly. So what we have to do is, we have to use the proper punctuation marks for us to understand the meaning of this sentence. So the creatures then marveled, saying, so here you know that each sentence begins with a capital letter. So we should say the creatures. So the first letter should be capital T. The T should be capital. The creatures then marveled, saying. So what did the creatures started marveled saying? What did the creatures say? How foolish we were to think only of the present. So whatever the words which are spoken by the creatures, they should be put in inverted commas. The exact words spoken by the creatures should be put in inverted commas, which are also called as quotation marks. So you can say the creatures then marveled, saying, after saying you need to take a pause, a comma, and open the inverted commas. So what did they say? How foolish we were to think only of the present. So in the within the inverted commas, the first letter should be always capital letter. So small h, we need to change it to capital H. How foolish we were to think only of the present. So here ends the sentence. So we need to put a full stop. How foolish we were to present, exclamatory mark, and close the quotation. And then yes, present. Okay. So you need to open the quotes because these are the exact words spoken by the creatures. So and the first letter within the inverted comma should be capital letter. So it should be capital H. How foolish we were to think only of the present. So full stop. And still the some more is to be continued for the by the creatures. Three cheers for the little squirrel. So these are also the words spoken by the creatures. So next sentence begins with again capital letter, capital T. Three cheers for the little squirrel. So we need to put an exclamatory mark and close the quotation. So this sentence should end with an exclamatory mark and you need to close the quotation. So once again let us repeat. The sentence should always begin with a capital letter. So the small t, we should change it to capital T. The creatures then marveled saying. So what did they say, all the creatures? How foolish we were to think of the present. Three cheers for the little squirrel. So all these are the words spoken by the creatures. So we have to put them in the inverted commas. So here put a comma for a short break here, for a short pause, and then open the quotation marks. How foolish. The first letter in the inverted comma should begin with a capital letter. So H should be W, H should be capital. How foolish we were to think of the present. Here ends one sentence. So we have to put a full stop at after present. And the next sentence starts with a capital letter again. It should be capital T. Three cheers for the little squirrel. So here, since it's an exclamatory sentence, it should end with an exclamatory mark and close the quotation marks. Now let us look at the second passage. The elephants enjoyed watching the fish swimming in the pool. The pythons, which were blessed with the long bodies, spoke well of the fine fur of the flat-footed rabbits. So again, the sentence should begin with a capital letter. So we say the elephants, capital T. The elephants enjoyed watching the fish swimming in the pool. Swimming in the pool. So here ends the sentence. So we need to put a full stop at the end. The next sentence starts. The pythons, which were blessed with long bodies. So when the next sentence starts, again you should begin with capital T. The pythons, which were blessed with long bodies, which were blessed with long bodies, spoke well of the fine fur of the flat-footed rabbits. So this sentence ends here, so we need to put a full stop at the end. Now, third passage. I will shine like sparkling sunshine, said the laburnum. My flowers will look like golden raindrops. So here I will. So I will should be replaced again. The sentence should begin with a capital letter. So we say capital I, and ILL stands for I will. It's a short form of I will. ILL is a short form of I will. So capital I, then put an inverted apostrophe, then LL. So it is a short form of I will. I will shine like sparkling sunshine. I will shine like sparkling sunshine. These are the words spoken by laburnum, said the laburnum. So these need to be, the words spoken by the laburnum should be in inverted commas. So open the quotes here and close the quotes here. And for a short pause, we need to put a comma here. Said the laburnum. here ends the sentence, so we need to put a full stop here. And next sentence is, my flowers will look like golden rain. So the next sentence should begin with a capital letter, so M should be capital. My flowers will look like golden raindrops. Golden raindrops. So the words my flowers will look like golden raindrops are also spoken by Lavanam. So we need to enclose them in the inverted commas. Put a full stop, open the quotes here and close the quotation here. Okay students, I hope you understood editing of the passages as well as the conventions of writing. What you have done that using the proper punctuation marks like question marks, comma, full stop, exclamatory mark and inverted commas. So now I want all of you to note down today's Sakshi classwork explained study material unit 1 page number 27 and 28. Homework is complete study material page number 27 and 28 and also revise editing which is on page number 27 and 28.